have it here. Do you need it there? No? Okay, can I have it?
Thank you.
differently, but very, very interesting to hear. So you're absolutely fearless. You have this enthusiastic approach to your music and no fear, right? You just like it very much. It's wonderful because, you know, when we play Mozart, we think it's the easiest composer to play when we're young and then the most difficult to play once we're older. Mm? Anyway, this piece, the Mozart one, it's a classical music. And as I was talking before, we need to know what we want. We need the characters. You need to know what you're expressing in every particular bit. You play well, but you play without many details. You have to find what you do in the right hand, what left hand sounds like. Probably not so much pedal, because pedal covers all the problems, right? Do you know what Mozart wrote, what he was liking to write the most? Operas. He loved theater. He loved operas. Why? Because they were different characters and he could do with them so many things. One would be laughing, one would be crying. You understand it, right? Can you start this a little bit slower than you played? Yes. Very enthusiastic. Music doesn't say anything, it's just loud. Yeah, what if you find, first of all, this, try to repeat these chords without pedal, so they are almost joint, almost. Don't lift your hand from the keys. Can you try? No, just left hand, only left. Imagine this strings, all the strings, they play, what is it called, detaché, detached. But it sounds almost like one harmony, like continuous harmony. That's better, it's much better than this. Much better, don't play percussive music in the left hand. All right? Now, this one, it's the same note repeated a few times, right? How do we, okay, I'll ask you this question. What do you think phrasing is?
Is that phrases?
Yes, it's like phrases. What do you think? What is phrasing? It's a certain length. We know we play to something, right? But essentially, phrasing means you play you express intervals. You agree? You play different intervals and you feel the distance, right? What would be the most difficult interval to phrase? Unison. Because this is also interval. It's not a repetition. Don't play it. It sounds too simple. Like da-da-da-da. Feel that interval within the same sound. Can we start again? No, it's just screaming. Just screaming. Cover it a little bit. Don't scream out too much. And make it musical. Try slower. This is half ending. And then another suggestion of something. Play this. Yes, it's nice. But here you have this one ending, but this one starting. You should do it at the same time. Ending. Same tempo. Musical playing. Yes. And also in Mozart music, you see this slow? And the end of the slow? It's on the second note, not on the third. da 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 da. Yeah, that's not staccato. And then what's this character? What's this character? Is it happy or unhappy? This one is happy or unhappy? This one? Happier, exciting, right? Let's make it exciting, but don't do this. Make it more It's mostly in the right hand, melody sings. Then different. Don't pedal, don't pedal, you don't need to pedal here. Yes, here at all. Second beat usually is not pushed. Louder, softer. Like continue. Continue. Like a melody, you play it like a scale, right? What if you shape it? Just a bit more beauty in the shaping. Let's play from here again. In the left hand when you play the trill, still the same. Like the still the same pulse when you play the trill. Can you do that? Probably third finger would be better here. Yes, and also, generally speaking, you use too much pedal. But here, it would be nice to pedal when you trill. Yes, yes, yes. And so on. So basically it has to be a bit more details, a bit more refined, balance between hands. Listen how sometimes right hand sings, left hand is under. Enthusiasm and this energy is very good, but it has to be more beautiful, okay? And also, of course, the parts where left hand suddenly starts to do all this expressive playing like this, you have to learn well without pedal. Can you do just left hand, only left hand? Slightly differently, instead of staying low hand and high fingers, try to be a little bit higher in your hand and roll through your fingers. So your hand actually shows the shape of the passage. Slowly, play slowly, slowly. Yes, yes, yes. Well, it's difficult to do it now. Not note by note, but more like shaping the whole phrase. Fingers are down. They have support. Don't lift them like this. Yeah, a bit more support. Try. Shape. It's all right. Yeah, this is just a general idea. It's okay. And when you finish the last chords, don't push them equally. The first is stronger. The other two are a bit less. Maybe a bit less. Dum, bum, bum. That's right. It's more Mozartish, a bit lighter. Do you know just last thing about Mozart? Mozart orchestra was mainly strings. So when you start to play just so big everything, it sounds like you have brass instruments, then lots of percussion, but Mozart didn't have that, right? Now, this one, what's the name of the composer? Right. Who was he? From where? Correct. And what would be the style of this composer? Very similar to Prokofiev. I mean, music is very different, but the style is close to neoclassic. I was talking about this just before, right? So it's very clear. And we don't have much time to do it in details, but there is something very interesting here. Just start. Okay. You played only four bars, and you had already two endings. This ending and this ending. What are the harmonies here? Just play it. Play this slowly. Just that. These chords. Can you play the chords? That's right. What is this? If you did your theory, do you do theory? What is this? That's tonic. And that's, what is this? Okay, this note is confusing. We will remove it just for now. What is this? It's a dominant seventh, so 5-1. What's interesting about this piece, that he has this, some music goes, and then 5-1. Then another bit of music goes, and again 5-1. What you should keep in mind, that every time you have the ending, you should cut it off from the music before. Can you start again? Finish this, finish, and then play 5-1. Do you understand me? So this last note here should be ending. You end it. And then play almost separately. Play tum pum. Tum pum. Continue. Tum pum. You understand? It's always a certain feature in this music which is everywhere. And then some parts here are very percussive. Some are melodic, da 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 da, but very soon it comes to the same, pum pum, right? Okay, thank you. We have to finish.